Good morning, and we can continue the discussion on institutionalist and a neo-institutionalist model. So, institutionalism, with its focus on legal and structural aspects of institutions. So, we know that what institutions mean. It means the structural or the functioning elements of a state or a government. So government has many organs, including legislature, executive, judiciary, bureaucracy, political leadership, other external factors, their interactions, their discussions, their decisions, all these come under institution, according to public policy analyst. So here, institutionalism with its focus on the legal and structural aspects of institutions. So institutionalist model focuses on the structural aspects of institutions. The structures and institutions and their arrangements and interactions can have a significant impact on public policy. So they believe that every public policy is made under a very detailed discussion and interaction within the institutions. So the structures and institution and their arrangements have a role in making policy. That is the say by the institutionalist theorist. So in the past, the government structures and institution have been a central focus of political science. So those who studied political science may know that the institutionalist model is a part of traditionalist approach of political science. In the traditionalist model of political science, institutionalism studied about the various institutions like legislature, executive, judiciary, like structures as to study political science. So to study political science, they used institutions as a source. So the institutional approach is there in political science. But later, when the behavioralism came, the political thinkers, the political scientists neglected the institutional approach. They say that only the structural functional aspects cannot determine the political interactions, political behavior of the system. So they neglected it. So the approach did not, however, devote adequate attention to the linkage between government structures and the content of public policy. That is a demerit found by the political scientist. Then the institutionalist approach was not backed by any systematic inquiry about the impact of these institutional characteristics on public policy decisions. So in making decisions, the institution, their interaction, their role, the relationship between the public policy and the structural functional working of the institutions are not connected. That is a demerit found by the political scientists. So they neglected it. But the public policy analyst like Thomas Dye says that governmental institutions are structured pattern of behavior of individuals and groups which persist over a period of time. So public policy analysts like Thomas Dye says that what it has some importance in public policy analysis. So the institutions or the structure or the function or the institution is already as part of a group of behavior. We can see there a group of interaction. Actually, in the institution, we can see the political workers, the decision makers are actually human beings, their interactions, their behavior is there. So we can study their interaction. That is a perspective by the public administration analyst. So the policy analyst says that the government's institutions are structured pattern of behavior of individuals and groups which persist over a period of time. We can see, so for example, if a communist government is in power, their interactions, their attitude will reflect in the institutions, in the legislature, its functioning, or in the functioning of bureaucracy, or in the functioning of secretariat. We can feel the communist characteristics somewhere. So that is the say by Thomas Dyes. He says that governmental institutions are structured pattern of behavior of individuals and groups. So we cannot neglect institutionalist model. Despite its narrow focus, the structural approach is not outdated. This says that this approach is not outdated. Government institutions are, in fact, a set of patterns of behavior of individuals and groups. So, we can see, നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ കഴിയും എന്താണ് ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽസ് വ്യക്തികളുടെയും ഗ്രൂപ്പുകളുടെയും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഓഫ് ആൾക്കാർ തന്നെയാണ് അവിടെ ഫങ്ഷൻ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അവരുടെ ഒരു ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ്, അവരുടെ ബിഹേവിയർ അവിടെ റിഫ്ലക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. സോ ദീസ് അഫക്ട് ബോത്ത് ദ ഡിസിഷൻ മേക്കിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ദ കണ്ടന്റ് ഓഫ് പബ്ലിക് പോളിസി. ഇപ്പോൾ പബ്ലിക് പോളിസിയുടെ കണ്ടന്റിൽ പോലും ഇത് റിഫ്ലക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. ദ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷണൽ അപ്രോച്ച് സജസ്റ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ദ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് മേ ബി സ്ട്രക്ചർഡ് ഇൻ സച്ച് എ വേ as to facilitate certain policy outcomes. കുറേ പോളിസികൾ പുറത്തേക്ക് വരുന്നതിൽ ഈ ഒരു ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസിൻ്റെ വലിയ റോളുണ്ട്. ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻ്റെ സ്ട്രക്ചറിന്, അതിൻ്റെ പാറ്റേണിൽ, അതിൻ്റെ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡിൽ, അതിൻ്റെ എവരി ഫങ്ഷനിങ് ഓഫ് ദ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് ഹാവ് എ റോൾ ഇൻ കണ്ടന്റ് ഓഫ് പബ്ലിക് പോളിസി. സോ ദീസ് പാറ്റേൺസ് മേ ഗിവ് ആൻ അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജ് ടു സെർട്ടൺ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഇൻ സൊസൈറ്റി ആൻഡ് വിത്ത് ഹോൾഡ് ദീസ് അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജ് ഫ്രം ദ അതർ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ്. ബട്ട് അവിടെയുള്ള ഒരു പ്രോബ്ലം എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ടൈം ദ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് ഓർ ദി ബ്യൂറോക്രസി ഓർ ദി സ്ട്രക്ചറൽ ഫങ്ഷണൽ ഓർ ദ ഫങ്ഷനിങ് ഓഫ് ദ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് മേ ആക്ട് ഇൻ ഫേവർ ഓഫ് സം ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റഡ് ഗ്രൂപ്പ്സ്. സോ ഇൻ ദ സൊസൈറ്റി those who have a strong influence on government institutions will have a major impact on the institutions. So that kind of reflection is there. So the institution may act in favor of these strong social groups. We cannot avoid it. In fact, they tend to favor some interest in society over others. So it will hinder the interest of some other groups. Certain individual groups may enjoy, therefore, greater power or access to government power under one set of structured patterns than under another set. So here is a competition is going on, a kind of competition. Who have major power on government or major might on the institutions will get the benefit over others. In other words, there is an impact of institutional characteristics on policy outcomes. So it will reflect on the policy outcomes. So in a society, there is a different social groups are there. But some social groups having, you know, may just think about the caste structure of Kerala society. So some caste groups have a major power in the politics. So they will influence the government. So the policy will be in favor of that particular social groups or the caste group sometimes, because as part of vote bank politics. So this some social groups, some caste groups, they have little influence on government, will not get adequate benefit. So the interaction between these social groups and the institutions will reflect on the content of public policy. So the making of public policy can be studied through institutions. That is the perspective by the institutionalist model. Under the institutional approach, one can study the relationships between the institutional arrangements and the content of public policy. The policy issues can be examined in a systematic fashion with a focus on institutional arrangements. Okay. The value of the institutional approach to policy analysis lies in asking what relationship exists between institutional arrangements and the content of public policy, and also investigating these relationships in a comparative fashion. So, the institutional approach tries to focus on the relationships exist between institutional arrangements and the content of public policy, and also investigating the relationship between as a comparative model. In a comparative model, however, it would not be right to assume that a particular change in institutional structure would bring about changes in public policy. So we cannot say that some kind of changes will reflect the that means every changes will change the content of public policy is not a is not happening every time. So we cannot say that every changes in policy every changes in the pattern of or the structure of institutions will reflect in public policy. For example, UDF government had brought the contributory pension in 2012 or 13, I think. When the other government, the left government, came to power, during the enactment of a contributory pension scheme, many opposition parties, mainly the Communist Party, opposed the scheme, and many strikes were there. And but when the left government in the power, they didn't change the scheme. They also continued the scheme because it is bureaucracy has some kind of power on some decisions. And so here the government decided to continue the scheme is very a best policy for the economy. So the structural change or the pattern, behavioral pattern or changes in the institutions here do not change any make any change in the content of the public policy. Okay, in this context, Thomas Dye says both structure and policy are largely determined by environmental forces, and the tinkering with institutional arrangements will have little independent impact on public policy if underlying environmental forces, social, economic, and political remain constant. So Thomas Dye says that structure, policy are largely, so there is a impact of environmental forces. So it already, every time it is repairing the institutional arrangements, the environment every time trying to repair or maintaining a kind of arrangements, maintaining a kind of influence on the institutions. But it cannot independently make any change because there is other factors is there, social, economic, political factors is there. That is the theory by the that is the model, institutionalist model. The main content of institutionalist model is these are the main content of institutionalist model. Okay, so we can move to the another model, that is a little some little addition to the institutional model, that is in neo-institutionalist model. We already discussed, studied it in the process approach, as part of process approach. So I just the same slide is used here, just you go through the slides. Okay, first, neo-institutionalist model is categorize public policy according to policy making subsystems. So a neo-institutionalist model focuses on the policies and how the policy act as a subsystem. So every policy has a as an inner mechanism. So inner mechanism as act as an a as an every subsystem act as a another institution. So that is the perspective with a neo-institutionalist more, neo-institutionalism. So neo-institutionalism more concerned about how different policy types. So they categorize all policies under four categories: distributive, redistributive, regulative, and constituent. And how this actually relate to the branches? How it working? That is a neo-institutionalist model. It will be more clear in the next slide. So, what is this distributive policy? Distributive policy provides benefits directly to each person. That is the main content of distributive policy. So, subsidy, government decided to give subsidy to income group C. So, what is redistributive policy? Government decided to extend subsidy to income group B also. So, there will be a chance of conflict between income group B and C. So that is the possibility of redistributive policy. And in a regulative policy, there is a provision of benefits is there, but already there is a control will be there. For example, Central Pollution Control Board enforces safety regulation and may punish the violators of those regulation. And constant policy means it is not directly affect the public, but as political person, they will be affected. For example, former Congress Minister Avadhar Henry has been rendered ineligible to contest a poll owing to his reissued vote in his dual citizenship. When these policies functioning as a inner mechanism, there is a power in it. Every policy has its own inner mechanism. So, distributive policy again. The inner mechanism directed it to it into a redistributive policy, and regulative policy itself has its own control. Regulations are there, so that kind of inner mechanism is making new policies or new changes in the policies, content of policy. So we can also include the aspects of the inner mechanism of this subsystem in the institutions. That is the perspective by the neo-institutionalist model. It is all about the neo-institutionalist model and institutionalist model. Okay, thank you.